Hi everyone, my name is Mitesh and I'm a developer advocate at NVIDIA. And welcome to this talk on building applications using LLM. As part of this talk, I will provide an overview of different applications that can be powered using LLMs. And I will also go through a few examples of these applications. So let's dive in. So as shown in this slide, there are many applications that can be powered using LLMs. I have grouped these applications into different categories such as text and content generation, conversational agents and search, robotics and embodied AI, co-pilot applications for productivity, and data analytics. I have listed a few applications in each of these categories, which are just a few examples. There are many other applications beyond this list that I have provided. In this talk, I would like to dive into three specific applications. In the past few tutorials, we have shown how to develop different chat applications that uses RAG or multimodal RAG, which are kind of conversational agents. One more application I would like to showcase is how the same architecture can be leveraged to develop an image search application. Secondly, I'll show how you can use various code assistant models out there and use it in your programming environment or configure it so that you can use it in your programming environment. And the third application that I'd like to showcase is how LLMs are powering different applications in robotics and embodied AI, where LLMs are becoming a natural interface to interact with robots to perform different tasks. So as I said before, multimodal RAG application can be developed for image search as well. In the past tutorials, you've seen how to leverage multimodal RAG when we convert information present in images to text representation. And this is used downstream to generate responses for the user. Looking beyond, the same RAG architecture can be leveraged where images are stored as embeddings in a vector database and used for image search. Here is an example of how a user provides a reference image along with a text question. The system retrieves similar images from the vector database and generates a response for the user. So this is how an image search workflow would look like. If you've seen our past tutorials, the workflow looks very similar. It's divided into two steps, an offline step and an online step. The things that you see on the right-hand side is an offline step where we create the vector database. And the things that you see on the left-hand side, once we have the vector database, the user might pass a text and image as their query. The text and images are used to retrieve the most relevant images and then use that information to create response for the user. So again, the steps are very similar. But the only difference you can foresee here is we are using an image embedding model to create embeddings from the images that we provide to the framework to create the vector database. So here is a code snippet of an example that I pulled from documentation of LlamaIndex. It's a very simple image search application that they have created, and it's easy to follow. On the left-hand side, you create a vector database using the image and text dataset. Once you have created that vector database, on the right-hand side, the snippet showcases how a user query along with a reference image can be passed to do a relevant image search in the vector database and create a response for the user based on the questions that the user is asking. Feel free to try it out. It's a really good example and very easy to implement. And they have a link that you can directly fire up this example in Colab. The other application that I would like to showcase is coding assistant and how one can bring their favorite coding assistant in their development environment. Now, there are many coding assistant models that are out there that one can use for their coding purposes. But before doing so, we will need to configure that in the development environment, and that is what I would like to showcase here. I use VS Code for my coding needs, and hence I'll showcase how to configure coding assistants for VS Code. So let's dive in. So this is what the high-level flow would look like. Before getting started, one will need to decide on a few things. The first one is which model you will use and where it is hosted, and what API protocol are used by the hosting services. For this application, I'll be using CodeStrel model hosted by NVIDIA Inference Microservice or NIM. The NIM microservices uses OpenAI protocol, and hence you'll need three pieces of information. The first information that you need is the name of the model, the link of the model endpoint, and the API information, the API key information. So we will use these three pieces of information and configure that in VS Code. So as I told you before, I will be using the NIM microservices hosted by NVIDIA. So in order to get the model, I will go to build.nvidia.com and search for the model. So I'm going to use CodeStrel, so I'm going to search for CodeStrel. And as you can see, there are many coding assistant models that are hosted on build.nvidia.com. Once you are there, copy the base URL, which will become your API base, the model name, which again has a string attached with it, and generate an API key by clicking on the Get API Key button. So once you have this information, we will use that information to configure in VS Code. Next, fire up VS Code and go to the marketplace. In marketplace, search for the app continue and install that. I have already installed it, so I don't need to take any other steps. Once installed, you will see the logo on your left panel. Click on that and go into the settings. Okay, once you're in settings, provide the model name that we copied from build.nvidia.com, the model URL, which is the endpoint, and replace and endpoints that into the API base, and then also provide the API key, which starts with NV API. Make sure to have provider's name as OpenAI, as NIM follows the OpenAI API protocol. So once you have these three pieces of information in there, you are ready to go. Now you can interact with your coding assistant while you are coding for various applications. So the last application I'd like to talk about is robotics and embodied AI. Now, LLMs are also finding its application for embodied robotics and behavioral learning. In this paradigm, instead of image captioning or visual question answering, what VLA model or vision language action models do is they generate action tokens from camera images and natural language instructions, which are used to control the motion of the robot. As you can see here in this video, this is an example of how you can control the motion of a gripper and a manipulator to perform different tasks, which are again using images captured by the camera and natural language interaction provided by the user. An example of a vision language action model that I'd like to showcase here is the Open Villa model, which was developed by researchers at Stanford, UC Berkeley, Total Research Institute, Google DeepMind, MIT, and Physical Intelligence. At a higher level, what this model does is it creates tokens from the captured image, which is fed to the Llama 2 model, along with the language instructions given by the user, which are tokenized as well. The model will generate an action for the robot. In this case, it will be translation and rotational motion of the gripper. But you can think of using the same paradigm, which can be extended to ground robots or humanoids as well. For further details of this work, feel free to visit the link openvilla.github.io, which are provided in this in this slide. So now that we know about vision language action model, or OpenVilla, which is one of the version of vision language action model, how can we get started? There is a really good tutorial developed by one of my colleagues, which is available on JetsonAILab.com, the link of which I have listed in this slide. Feel free to use that link. It has got a lot of rich material for various other robotics applications and how you can deploy them on Jetson devices. Coming back to this specific OpenVilla application, you can leverage this tutorial to both train or fine-tune your model for a specific application using your own proprietary data. And once you have your custom fine-tuned model, you can deploy the same on edge devices. In this case, it is Jetson Orin for inference purposes. As seen in this code snippet, you can run the trainer from the command prompt, or you can modify the script for your specific use cases. So you have the flexibility to do both. For inferencing purposes, on the right-hand side, if you can, as you can see, we have sufficiently abstracted the functionalities such that it reduces the overall deployment. Feel free to check out the tutorial. There is much more than what I have showcased here, the tutorials are well documented so that you can get started very easily. So to summarize, there are many LLM applications that one can develop, and there are many examples out there that one can leverage for to develop applications for different use cases. In this talk, I focused on three specific applications. One of them was on how you can use multimodal RAG architecture to do image search. The other example was how you can bring your favorite coding assistant models that are out there and configure it along in VS Code so that you can use it as a coding assistant. And the last application that we talked about was how you can bring LLM models along with vision models to create applications for robotics and embodied AI. So before I let you go, I would like to mention that at NVIDIA, developers and partners are instrumental to our success. We have a variety of engagement programs with our developers to help them get up and running on our platforms. feel free to visit developer.nvidia.com or use this barcode, which will get you there. And there's a lot of information available on that website. What I'd recommend is register for this program so you can keep yourself updated with various training material, blogs, learning material that we release to our developer community. And all of this is available free, of course, so you can harness this information to upgrade yourself. Thanks for your time. Thank you.